Welcome back, everybody. Our next guest is known as the Chef of Love. And he also happened to write his first book about love and relationships. These are many books, but the first one about love and relationships. Mm. Today, however, he is here making honey pineapple pork chops. Please welcome to our home for the very first time, hopefully not the last, Jernard Wells.
Yes. Thank you guys for having
Jernard.
Me.
One get the moniker Chef of Love?
You know, you'll be amazed. Chef of Love came as a young man. I wanted to always go out on dates. I wanted to entertain people.
Yeah.
And I knew how to cook from my father. And so I used that as an avenue because I didn't have a lot of money, but I knew, hey, it's still true. The quickest way to anybody's heart is through food.
Yep. That's true.
Yep. Yeah.
So you just started cooking for your dates and
next I did.
Thing you know, it stuck and you made a career of it.
I know. And the amazing thing is, I started cooking when I was 10 years old. And from there, when I turned 16, I came up with the bright idea I wanted to open up a restaurant out of my mother's kitchen. And that's what led into it. Yeah.
Wow. How does your mother feel about that?
You know,
it's
amazing. You know, the biggest thing is, it wasn't as big of a burden. I had $50 from cutting yards. And my father, that's one of the things that he did. He was disabled. Yeah. And from being disabled, he felt that he wasn't able to contribute to the household like he should. So every day he would cook nonstop. And so what I would do is I would get in the kitchen and I would just watch him and spend that time with him. And he didn't realize how I admired him for that.
Aww.
And that's what really led me into learning how to share. And that was the thing. When he passed away, and I was turning 16, going into my senior year, and that's when I came up with the idea. My father taught me how to cook, and I know how he shared his love through food. And so I had $50 from cleaning yards, pitched the idea, hey, I want to open up a restaurant. My mother said, where? I said, out of your kitchen, I only got $50. She said, you know, but you got to do it the right way. And I'm like, what's the right way? And she said, I need you to write out a business plan. She made me do all of that stuff.
Aww.
But lo and behold, who knew that that $50 wanting to buy a car just to go out on dates later on made me enough money to purchase my first brick and mortar restaurant.
Wow.
Yes, yes.
And now you're cooking in our kitchen.
Yeah. I know, right?
So you guys, go ahead, dig
in. Y'all dig in while we start whipping it up. And now what I have here, our honey pineapple chops, or as I call them, AKA Mississippi love chops.
Oh, nice.
We marinating them in a look. Apple juice and sea salt, and that actually helps enhance the flavor of them.
So how long do you leave those in the broth?
You know, you can do a minimum of an hour, 24 hours max, and that'll allow the citric acid from the apple juice to actually
make
infuse
it
on the inside of them.
Wow.
As well, the salt also pumps them up so that when you're cooking them, you don't have to worry about overcooking them because they have
out.
The excess juice.
Sure.
These are like so tender.
You know, that's the thing. We don't do rub around here. I do like what's the chewing little candies melt in your mouth, not in your hand.
There you go.
That's how we
Reese's
do.
Pieces. This is the Reese's Pieces of pork.
Exactly.
All right, and so you put some butter and some olive oil in there.
Yes, and what I did is then I dropped a little of our rosemary in there.
Ooh, nice.
And because the rosemary helps infuse and makes the flavors just enhanced.
Now, do you always do a cast iron skillet?
You know, I believe cast iron is the way to go. Anything else would be uncivilized. You know, and plus you want that good sear, and that's what I want. If you notice the good sear and the caramelization over it, that's what we wanted. Now, the key is to always work in unanimous. Why I got that first sear going on the chops.
Sure.
Now what we're going to do is we're going to take our honey, and we're going to infuse it in our gochujang sauce.
Oh, your what?
A what?
Gochujang, that's Korean for sweet and spicy sauce.
Oh.
And it gives you the best of both worlds. Because that's what it's about. It's about showing people, hey, I can give you the hot and I can give you the love. It depends on which end of the sword you are.
Wow. That's true. So then you just put some pineapple?
Some pineapple and minced garlic in there.
Right.
And then we just
really
blend
it
in real good.
Yeah. Oh
because, and the key is, you don't have to do a lot of mixing with this.
Okay.
Because once we actually add it to the heat, it's going to break down.
Okay.
Now as you see, what we do is we take these and you just brush the top.
As you're cooking them, oh, I
yes,
love
but
that.
Notice I flipped them and got that first sear.
Mm-hmm. Would you ever do this in the oven?
You can do it in the oven, but doing it in the oven is for rookies.
You want to
make sure you sear it good.
Mm.
And actually, and the funny thing is, with cooking this way, it is what led me into everything that I've done. Me and my wife, we've been married now for almost 20 years.
Wow.
And we have 9 children.
I mean, Nine.
Yes,
children.
Five girls and four boys.
Isn't that crazy?
Not only am I the client, but I'm the president. But that's only, that's only seven of them right there. I have two that are off in college right now.
Can I ask you something? Yeah. With I'm one of three, and my mom called me every single name of every sibling.
Yeah, right.
How do you get it wrong all the time? You say, what? No.
You know, my name starts with a J. I'm Jernard, and my wife's name is Keena. So every name has a J and K, but the last one is 8 years old. We named her Zoe with a Z.
You're never going
to forget right there, yeah.
You're never going to forget that one. So you have five girls and four boys.
Five girls and four boys.
Oh, my goodness.
I have three girls that are the oldest. I have a 23-year-old, a 20-year-old, and a 19-year-old, and then the boys, and then the other two are the youngest girls. Now, that's one thing that leads me into my latest book, Roadmap, A Woman's Guide to a Good Man.
That's what I was going to say. They must be the inspiration.
Boy. Yes, it is. And then the fact of when you have girls and you're dad and you're overprotective, and me always trying to share advice with them because they always come home and they're like, oh, this boy did this and my boyfriend this. And when I'm trying to share the advice to them, they don't want to accept it.
Well, you're
from
their
me.
Dad.
Yeah, but the thing is, they're like, I don't want to hear what you got to say. You don't know what you're talking about. I'm like, I've been there and done that. Nine times out of ten, I was that guy. So, man, I'm being honest. Hey, remember, I did cook for love.
Literally. Literally.
So what I did was I created a book that broke down in 14 chapters, 10,000 words, the different psyches of a man. So you know which one you got. You got the jealous man, the egotistical man, the mama's boy, the solitary man, the arrogant man.
Get closer, Larissa.
Hey, hey, listen.
Closer, Larissa.
Larissa's looking for a good man.
Can I get a copy of this?
Yes, you can. As a matter of fact, you can get it at chefdenard.com or at any Barnes & Nobles. But on the other hand, you got me here today giving it to you firsthand. So that's better than reading out of the book.
I'm going to pull you up.
She's Hollywood and me right
now.
No,
I mean, I'm sure you feel like that at home with five girls.
Oh, you'll be amazed. But the thing is, I took the experiences they were going through, all the experience of my wife's friend, and I said, let me show you how to understand the male. Now, granted, guys were upset because they was like, man, you're telling all the secrets, you're telling how I do. And I said, no, I'm making it easy for you. Because if I tell her how you operate, guess what? You ain't got to lie about who you are anymore.
Yeah.
Yes.
Exactly. Get in here.
Exactly.
You guys
have to. Yes. Oh, man.
You would like to enjoy this, go to HallmarkChannel.com. We will have the recipe available there for you. Again, if you would like some relationship advice, follow Chef Jernard on his Twitter, @ChefJernard, and be sure to pick up a copy of Roadmap, A Woman's Guide to a Good Man. Larissa will be standing in front of you
and
mine, wherever books are sold. Coming right back, and we're going to step into spring style with Allie.
Yes, there are some super cute new shoe trends for spring this year, and I'm going to tell you all about them next.